A7c II here. 20 millimeter Viltrox. Thank you, Randy. Okay, so I probably look a little wet. I just came in from working outside. There's another hurricane out there, Milton. So this is the time of year when that stuff happens. You just can't help it. Let's go out real quick. So I'm looking at things that can blow around. All right, so what the problem is with hurricanes, just so you guys know, is they're not predictable. It's not that, oh, the news media knows exactly what's going to happen, because the problem is they don't. And that's what happened, and I lived through it, with Hurricane Andrew. Wasn't supposed to come here, and yet it destroyed South Florida. Why? Because it did a little warble at the end, and it moved it right down through the south part of Miami, through Homestead area and stuff like that. And the damage was, it looked like a bomb zone. So those that have experience with this stuff, you gotta watch. You gotta watch and look and see what's going on. You can't just, you know, get complacent. And just be prepared. And once you get prepared for the first one, it carries through to the next ones. So I took the Panasonic S5 Mark II and I put it up as an overhead camera. Let me show you. When I do the live shows, I sit here and the rest of the room is behind me back there. And I've got the three main cameras in the front. But I needed an overhead camera. So I took the S5 Mark II, which is a Panasonic Lumix, very high-end camera, and I put it up on the ceiling. All right, so that bracket is being held on there. That's the front side. Now let me go around and show you the back side. So those are the drop ceiling bars, and that is the back side holding the camera. That's the only part that's not that terrific, is because it's not quick to take it up and pull it down. I want to be able to just grab that camera and go use it. That was the Sony 85 millimeter lens I put on there to get you really close so you could see what's up above me. So that's about it for today. I'll be keeping an eye out on a quick way to clip and unclip that camera. So I got two electronic wires going to it. One is an HDMI cable, and because it's a full-size HDMI port, there's no adapters as necessary. And the other is I have a USB-C plug that keeps the battery charged. And once it's charged, I just turn the whole thing on. I just unplug it. So it takes care of that. So last Friday night, you saw me with the overhead camera. So I need to make a video because of the hurricane and Rosh Hashanah and stuff like that. I've kind of dragged my feet on sending the E10 Mark II back to B&H. So today, tomorrow, I need to get that video done. What the heck am I waiting for? Do I still look like a mess? Because I got all wet outside. I'll be getting wet on and off this whole week because it's going to be a rain event. The unique thing with the hurricanes this time, Helene and now Milton, is they're super, super wide. It's going to go up in the Tampa area, what it looks like in the last report. We're still going to feel some nice, hefty winds down here and some heavy, strong rains. So that's what it does to us. All right, keep me in your prayers. I keep you in my prayers. I'm back on the 20 millimeter 2.8. And this is handheld, no sticks, no nothing, no tripod, no gimbal on the bottom of it. And I'll run this through Gyroflow because it's now running between 50 and 60 frames per second. I found a way to up it, and that the simple answer is let it use the GPU. Click that on. When it does, it went from 13 to 14 frames per second of development or processing time to between 50 and 60 frames per second. So I'm shooting this at 24p, 24 frames per second. So when I've been doing it all this time, I've been processing it at 12 to 13 frames per second. So if I have a 10-minute clip, it takes 20 to 25 minutes to get it done. Now, in Catalyst Browse, wow, it would take not 20 to 25 minutes, it would take an hour to get it done. Now, whatever the clip is, it takes maybe 4 minutes, 5 minutes. So we are in such a winning streak going on here. All right, guys, rambling. Talk to you later. Love you. Bye.
You have just watched another PeterGregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch PeterGregg. Thank you for watching.